Cockleshell Bay is a town near the sea with seagulls and sunshine and sound. There are shops that sell ices and bright coloured kites that will fly from a string in your hand. There are white painted houses along the seafront, and one's called the Bucket and Spade. It's where people stay and two children play with all the good friends that they've made. So meet Robin and Rosie of Cockleshell Bay. There was a lot of excitement in the air of Cockleshell Bay, and most of it seemed to be coming from the kitchen of the Bucket and Spade guest house.
Now, you won't put anything on top of that, will you?
Well, I'm going to put jam inside it.
Jam, Mrs. C? Oh, I hope you ain't. You'll ruin it.
Sorry, Gran. Ruin it?
Ruin what? My beautiful... Well, what I got in that there box?
I never said I... Oh. I said I was going to put jam in the cake when it's baked.
Oh, well, I never... I thought as it were a funny thing to do. Oh!
Oh, Gran, really.
Mum, hello, Gran. We can't think of anything to make for our Easter fare.
Ooh, what's in that box, Gran? Ooh, none of your business.
Oh, go on, tell us.
No! Well, is it anything to do with our Easter fare?
Well, it might be.
What's that you're making, Mummy?
Oh, it's the same as what's inside Gran's box.
Oh, what?
None of your business.
Oh, Mummy.
I bet it's something for our Easter fare. I knew you'd be doing something,
Mum. Do you want
Mum?
Me to put the decorating
I
table...
I bet it's a sponge.
Oh, hello, Gran.
I bet it is.
Morning, Mr. C.
Oh, go on, tell
this
us, Mummy.
This place is a madhouse. I can't hear myself think.
Gran and I have got lots to do, and we can't get on if the kitchen's full of chattering people. All right, come on, kids. We'll get out of Mummy's way.
Yeah, yes, all okay. Right.
Give me a shout when you've finished, Helen, and I'll start getting things ready for the fair, okay?
All right, Chris.
Now then, Mrs. C, we'd better get down to it.
Now then, what are you two going to do?
Well, we want to make something.
Yeah, but we can't think of anything to make.
Well, have you asked Mr. Ship if he's got any ideas?
Oh, no. We could do that.
Yeah. We'll go there now, shall we?
Well, don't be a nuisance now.
No, we won't.
Right, Dad. Daddy. See you later.
Mr. Ship? Hello, Mr. Ship?
Shh.
Oh, what is it, Mr. Ship?
There's something going on in my shed.
Oh, what?
Well, you just keep very quiet and listen and see if you can't guess.
All right. Oh, it sounds like birds.
Quite right. There's a blackbird's nest up there, and I think as the eggs has just hatched out.
Oh, lovely. Great.
Now, if you're very careful and quiet, you can climb up my ladder and take a look.
Wow!
Shh!
Oh, sorry.
Right. Rosie first. Now, I'll see as you don't fall, my dear.
Oh, they're lovely. Oh,
come on, Rosie. I want to see.
All right, I'm coming down.
Oh. There now. Right, Robin, your turn to go aloft, eh?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, they're funny, aren't they?
Why have they got their mouths open, Mr. Ship?
Because they're like you two.
Always hungry.
Oh, Mr. Ship.
Here, come on, Robin. Better let Mr. and Mrs. Blackbird get back to their nest so as they can feed their children.
All right.
coming.
Oh, that was great, Mr. Ship. Thanks. Yes.
Oh, a real sign of spring, that, eh? There'll be beaks a-gaping open in nests all over the place soon.
Yeah. Oh, hey, Robin, I've got an idea.
What, Rosie?
For the Easter fair, yes, for something we can make.
What?
Ah, well now, Rosie, you better keep it a secret, eh? So as it'll be a surprise, like my surprise.
Ooh, what's that, Mr. Ship?
Oh, bless my barnacles. If I told you that, why, it wouldn't be a surprise now, would it?
No.
Right. Well, you stick to your own, eh?
Yeah. Listen, Robin. Oh, hey, Robin.
Promptly at 2 o'clock that afternoon, Robin and Rosie's Easter fair began. Springtime fun for all the family. Sideshows and surprises in aid of needy donkeys with special guest appearance of F. Donkey Esquire.
Ah, come on now, Mr. C. Where's it going to be? Sure, and you'll have to have a go soon. I've got hundreds of people waiting their turns.
All right, the Fingle. Here goes.
Well, I never.
How was it? Oh! Oh, dear.
If only that there donkey had been facing the other way, Mr. C. You'd have won a prize. Here, cheer yourself up with a go of my granny's hat. Penny a go.
Ah, so that's what was in the box.
Ha ha! Ain't she a beauty? A real Easter bonnet.
Well, I might as well carry on making a fool of myself, I suppose. All right. There you are.
Thank you, sir. And there you are. Oh, hey. Oh, look at that now.
There.
Oh, Daddy.
Bless my barnacles, Mr. Cockle. You needs a nice bit of music to go with that there floribundacious hat.
Floribund.
A nice bit of music. Here, you can have a dance too if you like.
Gosh, I can't resist that, Mr. Ship. Well, the music anyway. I don't think I could dance with this lot on. Here's the penny.
Thank you, sir. Pop it in the slot then. Right, here we go.
That's lovely, ain't it? It's great. Oh, beautiful.
Marvellous, Mr. Ship.
Here you are, sir.
Oh, madam.
Rosie. All right. What do I do here?
Only a penny, sir, to feed the baby bird.
Hmm, a penny, eh? What's it eat? Cheese and chutney sandwiches.
Oh, no, it eats sweets.
Buy a sweet for a penny, Daddy, sir, and feed it to the little bird.
Well, it's the biggest little bird I ever saw. Okay, here's a penny.
Thank you, sir, and here's the sweet.
Cheep, 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 cheep. Oh. Ah, thank you.
Well, that's great. Has your mother had a go? Hey, where is she?
She had a go, and then I think she went into the house to get... Oh, look, she's coming. Hey, what's she got?
Ta-da!
Gosh!
Great Scott, Helen, what kind of a cake is that? Ha-ha! This is a Robin and Rosie Easter fair for the donkeys super special bird's nest cake.
Oh, look here now.
Bless my barnacles.
Ah, will you look at that now?
Well, well, Mrs. Cockle, if it tastes as good as its name is long, there's nothing in the whole of Ireland would stop me having a taste of it.
and everyone crowded round for a piece of Mrs. Cockle's Robin and Rosie's Easter Fair for Donkeys super special Bird's Nest